Greetings, Earthlings. I'm going to make porcupine meatballs today. So what I'm doing is mixing up the regular recipe just a little bit, see if I can get a little bit more flavor. I have 1.5 pounds of ground beef, 1/2 of a ginormous onion chopped up, kind of fine, but not fine enough, but my hand hurt. So I'm going to put that in there. And I've got about 1.5 teaspoons of Himalayan salt and 1/2 of cracked black pepper, 1/2 cup of short grain rice. Why am I using short grain? That's what makes it porcupine. Now I've got a 1 can of condensed tomato soup and enough milk to make it like 2 1/4. I'm going to put maybe 1/2 of this in here. Yes, I'm listening to my eclectic. Oh, that looks like about 1/2 cup. Then also to this, I'm just going to add more liquid. I'm going to put in maybe 3/4 cup of water. Usually you just do the water and tomato soup on top, but I want to try and get a little more mater flavor. Okay, I'm going to mix this up. I'll be right back. Alright, I'm going to do it with one hand because, you know, I'm not going to do the other hand. So you want to mix up really well, but you don't want to like compress it where it'll be rubber balls instead of meatballs. This is really cold. I'm using, I think it's 90% ground beef that we got at Costco. And usually Hungry will pick it up for me, and he always gets these ginormous packages. And I have to make them into hamburger patties so they freeze efficiently, and I know what I'm doing when I'm grabbing little burger thingies to make a recipe. But this time he bought me some pucks, you know, squeezed out of the machine pucks, and they work out better because each puck is about 1/2 pound. So 3 pucks. Alrighty. Now I have to turn you off because I need 2 hands. Then I'm going to wash my hands. I forgot to cover Mr. Flip. But anyway, that's that. Okay, I'll be right back. I'm in the Hawaiian state of mind in honor of cooking and crafting Beth, Yo-Yo Max 12, and Gigi, who had a fantabulous little vacation. Okay, I'm just using this little bitty cookie scoop. Of course you can't see it. See? I'm not going to roll them because I don't see any reason to roll them and hurt my hand because I have to go somewhere tonight. Okay. So just keep filling it up. You should get a whole boatload. Let's see how many you'll get. Well, maybe I'll roll them. They look kind of sloppy. That's Izzy playing his ukulele. May he rest in peace. He's fabulous. Lovely voice. Love to sing and play. He's all over YouTube if you want to look him up. Anyway. We had a luau a couple years ago. I wish I could post the video public, but, you know, I'm dealing with like 200 people, and not everybody likes the fact that I do YouTube. So, anyway, if you have leftover meatballs, go ahead, put them on a sheet pan, and freeze them, and then pop them into a Ziploc. And you have another easy-to-make meal ready to roll. And the next time, maybe you'll make cream of something else, you know, instead of tomato. maybe you'll make mushrooms. Hungry likes it with mushrooms. My friend Barb, she loves it with mushrooms. I like it tomato soupy. But this is the last time we'll ever make this with a can of condensed. I mean, I got the no MSG stuff. It was the last can in the pantry. But I read the label and I put my glasses on. And it's got high fructose corn syrup. Anyway, makes a whole bunch of meatballs. So I'm going to roll these and line them all up like little soldiers, and I'll be right back. 35. Plus, you know, that much left over. Usually I don't have any left over. Hear this song? It's Johnny Cash. At our luau, Hungry played and sang this as the last song. And it just makes me want to cry. Anyway, now you take the leftover of your liquid, drown them, it was such a nice luau, nobody could believe how wonderful it was. If you could have seen the girls, my girlfriends, millions of them, doing the hukilau dance while my husband, Hungry Hubby, played the music and Patty Cake Water Sprite sang. She has a beautiful voice. Anyway, it was just so cute and so nice. From the oldest to the little toddlers, they were all doing the hukilau. Anyway, now I'm going to cover this, and I'm going to let them sit for about half hour. Be right back. Alrighty, so I'm covering this with cling because, well, this is stretch tight the best, I think. And, because I'm going to cover it with foil, and I don't want foil touching the food. Ew, foil on the food. Alright, that's good enough. And after about half hour, I'll cover it over with foil. Be back. Alright, so shiny side up, this is what my Mama Mia taught me, reflects the heat back into the oven. Shiny side down absorbs the heat into the food. Does it make a difference? I don't know. I've done it both ways. And I can't tell any difference whatsoever. Perhaps it's the cling that's doing it. But anyway, now I let it sit for about an hour and a half. It looks good, so. Alright. That's on cattywampus. And look, I had 6 little meatballs left over. That'll make a nice lunch sometime later. Tomorrow he'll have leftover porcupine meatballs in his lunch. And that's that. Oh, here you go. This is the hukilau song. Yep. In honor of Hungry Hubby and Patty Cake Water Sprite. Why do I call her that? Because it's her name. She is the master of chocolate cake. And, I mean, we all make the same recipe, but nobody makes it like Patty Cake. It's like 2 9x13 stacked pounds of chocolate frosting. And then she gets her daughter to decorate the cake. And it's always requested at every get-together we have. So, why do I call her Water Sprite? Because she is. Okay, now I'm going to put it in the oven at 350 degrees for about 1 hour. And I'll see you then. Steamed broccoli and carrots. Let's see how badly I can get a steam burn. I just can't see so well. Ooh! I'm afraid. afraid of this. I need a tool. Okay. Ooh, look at those little porcupines. Can you see them poking out there? I don't know if I can zoom in. I'm not good at this. Anyway, the short grain rice pops up and looks like little porcupine quills. And that's why they're called porcupine meatballs. Okay, let's serve them up. Okay, where's your dish? I can't see. Oh, Hungry's scooping it up.
Uno más.
I did a little bit differently on. Okay. Ooh. Ah. Okay. You want to take a bite? Or do you
want to? No.
It's pretty darn hot. Okay. Well, there they are. We'll get a review in a second. Whoops. There we go.
You know what I'm saying?
Honey, I'm telling people how wonderful this is. Okay, so I've got wonderful porcupine meatballs, some steamed veggies with some Himalayan salt on it, and now we'll get a taste test from Hungry Hubby. What do you think, hon?
I have to eat one first.
Oh, that helps to 'cause I did make them a little differently. I did it more, I think, tomato-y. So,
They're good?
Just good. They're only good, folks. Okay, we'll talk to you again. Okay, like Hungry Hubby said, they are good, but not fantabulous. So we decided the original recipe, which I will put down below, is better. What happened when I used the cling, the stretch tight, was they steamed so much. I mean, that gives them nice little porcupine effect, but they just were too soupy. The gravy was too soupy, so I'm going to do a little cornstarch dance on them and thicken it up just a little bit. You know how to do that. I don't need to tell you. Also, the pink salt, Himalayan pink salt, was a little bit less salty than regular salt, so I would suggest, I think it was 1.5 teaspoons of that. I would suggest 1¾ to 2 teaspoons of that. Otherwise, it was good. So when that comes up, I'm just going to thicken it and see if I can move you. Pour it over those two lovely lunch containers for Hungry Hubby. Whoop, okay, there. And that's the end of that. And this time I'm really hanging up on ya. Bye.